And now we will learn about when the owner invests money or assets into the company. This is also paying business expenses from personal funds. It's very obvious that if the owner takes cash from their personal bank account and deposits it into the company bank account, or takes equipment from his or her home and brings it to the office for exclusively business use, those two situations are clearly owner's investment. However, did you know if the owner pays a business expense from a non-business account, that also counts as owner's investment? This is true even if other assets are brought from the home to be exclusively used for business. What happens when you pay a business expense from a personal account? Well, the company received a service that they have used or expended. They need to record that expense as a legitimate business expense. The owner has taken personal funds and put it towards his business needs. That's investment. The investment belongs recorded in the owner's capital account with all the other investments into the business. This is true even if for the owner's credit card charges or if the owner pays cash. It doesn't matter how they pay. If it comes from the owner's personal funds, credit card, cash, check, or bank account, it counts as owner's investment and the business has a specific business expense. For example, let's imagine on April 5th, Holden pays $500 from his personal bank account for a business delivery and he gives check number 61. The company has $500 more in delivery expense and Holden has invested $500 more in his business. He has $500 more owner's equity in the company. So let's take a look at what the results should look like if we record this properly. Let's open the trial balance. Now we know we will have more delivery expense. Delivery expense is starting this fiscal quarter as zero. So if Holden pays delivery expense, it doesn't matter if he pays it for business or for personal. His business received a delivery for $500, so his business should record $500 as delivery expense. And $500 should show up right here after we record the transaction properly. Holden's equity, which is what we're calling Holden's capital, this number represents his investment. Before the April 5th transaction, he only invested a total of $30,000 into the company. But now that he's paying $500 of the business delivery from his personal, that means he's investing $500 more into his company, and this result should show $30,500. So how do you record that? Very simple. We open the register for Holden's capital or equity account and record it there. All you have to do is open the chart of accounts, usually by clicking List, Chart of Accounts, and here we have Holden's equity. This is his capital account. This is the account that records anytime Holden invests money into the business. To open the register window for this or any account, just double click on the account in the chart of accounts and the register window for Holden's equity, or you could call it Holden's capital, would open up. Now the format that it displays now is showing you two lines for each one transaction, because this is the way registers looked in the old days before a computer. If you like, you can click the check mark at the bottom here and make it one line per transaction. I like to see it one line per transaction, even though the fields that you input are the same. To me, it's easier to see. So I'm going to leave this checked off, but you don't have to. You can enter it individually into these fields. So it's the same thing. So we click here, and we go back to April 5th, which is the date that Holden paid the company's delivery expense. The check number, well, it was drawn from his personal account, but it's still a good idea to write down what check number it was. Now, we don't know whom he paid, so we can leave that blank, but in the future, whomever he paid, you'd put here. But the account is delivery expense. Delivery expense. Because you're in the equity register, which means this is going to go up by 500, and so is delivery expense. Remember, first of all, if you put 500, it's always an increase to Holden's owner's equity because he paid something from his personal. So if you paid something from personal in the equity or capital register, you put the 500 in the increase column. Now the result is what we promised it would be, 30,500. And if we look at the trial balance now, we see Holden's equity is 30,500, and we also notice delivery expense showed up here for the first time as $500. Please note, very important, if you track expenses by customer or job, you cannot do it this way. You must instead watch the following video to input that particular situation correctly.